Okay, so our next game here is Under the Skin, one that I've been looking forward to playing for a while. Actually, I've never played this game, but I am loosely familiar with it. I think it might be best to just let the game speak for itself once we get in here, but basically this is my favorite alien invasion game, more than Destroy All Humans. So we'll do a story mode. There is a versus mode, but unfortunately I don't have anyone to play it with. So we have to get 300 coins. I have 5 minutes, but watch out for Becky, who's that cute little blonde alien over there. I love the aesthetic style of this game. It's super, super great for me. It's exactly what I like. Okay, so we start out already a human, looks like. Now, the way this game works, and I don't know exactly how to do it, but we're supposed to basically annoy humans, and then that gives us coins. That's all I know. I believe that we can, take over different people. I don't know exactly how to do it, but right now, we've taken over a cheerleader, and we annoy people by, doing different things. Oh, wait, we lost our clothes. Okay, I think that's our health. Hold on. So let's see. Can I scan a new human? It doesn't seem to be working. There we go. Alright, I did something wrong. I don't know. Okay. So because I scanned that human, and they have to go under the UFO, I guess, to get the new, shape. So I'm a new character, which means those people that were chasing me aren't chasing me anymore. Wait, I don't know. Okay, I don't know. I don't know how exactly what I'm doing, obviously. But I'm just trying to get a new person, but I don't know exactly how it works. Looks like I've got tax and karaoke as my main annoyance things. Hold on, let's try. Okay, I'm a new person. All right. I've never played this before. I just kind of know what it is. Let's try karaoke. Get some coins from doing karaoke in public. When people annoyed, their heads get big, which is pretty funny, I think. Okay. So wait, panic time. I don't know what panic time is. Does mean people are dropping more coins? Because I noticed there's a lot more giant coins now. I think I've got the right number. Oh crap! I got run over by that car. It just knocked my clothes off. I would be like complaining about the like sexualization with the clothes knocking off thing, but honestly, the game's so cute looking, I don't even care. It's not nearly as sleazy as other games we've played. It's a lot more, even though we're running around in striped underwear here, it's way more tasteful than a lot of other games we've played where you have characters running around naked for whatever reason. And it works on every character, it just happens that I've been a woman every time. I don't know exactly what I did to make that happen, because I don't know exactly how to do the scan. There we go, like that time I knew I scanned her. In the past I don't know. So is that other person with the gun, is that the... what's her name that it was warning me about? I guess it must be. I'm looking for another UFO thing so I can change. This guy's just chasing me around with the gun. I'm assuming that's the other alien. And that she can also change shapes like I can. Because we haven't seen myself in my alien form this whole game. I'm thinking that might be the next stage of the health. Like I have a couple of different health options. We're back to being the cheerleader again. When you look at a person, it tells you what options they have. I guess I used up all of the cheerleader's options before. So let me get this child. I don't have another... wait, here's a UFO changing station over here on the map. Looks like, I can find it. Here we go. Okay, so now I'm a child. The child has lots of tax and electricity. I don't know why I have electricity, but that's pretty good. So the way to do this properly, I guess, would be to drop out your annoyance things in large crowds to get lots of people annoyed. Wait, panic time again. Why is there... I don't know what the deal is with this other guy. He's naked now, too. But any... I got... You ran over a kid, dude. Horrible person. Okay, so now... Now, the kid's in her underwear. But thankfully, it's pretty... pretty conservative underwear there. So, anyway, we won! Just right before I got hit by a car again. I did it. And now here we get to see some more... So, yeah. That's the most of this game I've ever seen at one time, but I liked it. I had a feeling I would. Really just the style and approach to the game, I think, is a lot of fun. But the gameplay was pretty fun, too. Too bad we only got to play it for a few minutes. Next up here we have Jack 3, which looks like it only has menu controls? Oh, it's the in-game control screen for each level. Okay. So that means we're probably getting multiple levels, like with the Spyro demo, and they're probably very different levels, also like with the Spyro demo. We've played the Jack and Daxter franchise a few times here on Demo Reel. I'm not really a fan. Like, it's not that different from a lot of other games I do like. It's just, I guess because I didn't grow up with it, maybe, it's not as charming to me. Like, by the time Jack and Daxter was coming out, I was already a teenager, and I didn't really care as much about... mascot games, even ones that are like trying to be edgy like this one, maybe even less ones that are trying to be edgy like Jack and Daxter. Like, I think Crash Bandicoot's my top level of edginess that I can really get into. Anyway, it looks like Jack's been captured.
By order of the Grand Council of Haven City, for heinous acts and crimes against the people, you are hereby banished to the wasteland for life.
This is a death sentence, Vigor. There must be another way.
Your protest was overruled. This dark eco-freak is dangerous. Now drop the cargo! This is an outrage! I am outraged beyond words! Although I do have something to say. Not everyone agrees with this ridiculous decree.
Yeah, we want a recount.
Oh, I see you wish to join him. Actually, we are not that outraged. Farewell, Jack. Stay out of the sun. Drink lots of water, if you can find it.
Jack?
Go back to the city, Dax.
I'm sorry. The council is too powerful. There was nothing
I know.
You just stay alive, you hear me? That's an order. Someone will find you. I promise.
May the precursors have mercy on you.
Okay, so we're all alone in the desert, I guess. With a little yellow
Daxter.
Light.
Don't thank me. I'm only here because you wouldn't last a second without me. Okay, tough guy. You got us into this mess. Now you gotta get us out!
Ah, what a team we'll make!
Let's just get moving. But which way?
That way!
That way!
Oh, and I suppose you know where you're going, huh?
Better than you do, Bent Beak!
Let's just move.
He's not very grateful. They're risking their lives for no reason other than loyalty to him.
This was all your stupid idea!
No, it was yours! Only a bird brain could have thought this one up! Let's go with him! We'll help together! You mean we'll die together?!
I can't believe this city hates us.
We saved those lowlifes!
We're gonna find out what happened now?
Jack, the city's divided. Reports say new Crimson Death Bots are holding the vital section of the industrial area. My men are getting their asses kicked. The KG have a new leader. We're trying to find out who it is.
I'm afraid I've got more bad news. A large group of surviving metalheads have concentrated in another section of the city.
But we destroyed Kor.
It appears the strongest metalheads have survived. The battle for the city has just begun.
The people are blaming you, Jack.
Okay. So, we got kicked out because we defeated our enemies?
Right.
I guess I can understand that.
Good plan, Jack. A nap would be nice.
Okay, this is where they all die.
Rest.
This bird is overcooked.
The bells.
I can't say I'm too beat up about it. I never really liked any of these characters.
Report!
It's bad. The city's become a battlefield. Mechanized death bots have taken the industrial section. And the surviving metalheads have expanded their hold on the west side. We're losing ground on all fronts.
The council's meeting tonight in emergency session. Rumblings about you, Jack. It doesn't look good. They think your friendship with Crew helped the metalheads get into the city.
You don't believe that, do you?
What's in the past is done. Right now, metalheads are assaulting the palace. They're looking for something, and I have no idea.
Okay, I don't know who Crew is, or even what a metalhead is now that I think about it. I've only ever played these games from the video. And there goes, I guess, the Capitol building? This seems like a pretty big deal. How many people are in that building? Like, a lot of people are dying right now, right? Like, that's what we're watching in this game? This kid's game? Okay, well, it happened. Oh, somebody found us. That's good.
Looks like we found some live ones. Barely. Here's the beacon we were picking up. Who gave you this? We'll take them with us. Let's move. I smell a storm coming.
I see a storm coming. I don't think you need to smell that. But okay, so now we're actually at the menu here. So let's see. How many levels do we have? We have 3 missions. Let's see how long they take. I'd like to do all of them if I can. But, like, that video was already kind of long. It wasn't insanely long, but it was several minutes. And each of these looked like
another
video, too.
You guys looking for a bit of action? The scope shows a group of metalheads moving through the desert not too far from here. I don't like metalheads almost as much as I don't like you. And you've got some proving to do. Intercept those bad boys and give them hell. Who knows? You might even get a few toys for your effort.
Why does it sound like you're leaving out the dangerous parts? Jack, I'm getting some nasty juju vibes here. I don't have these whiskers for nothing, you know.
I don't
Relax.
See any whiskers.
We could handle a few metalheads.
Have you ever seen a wasteland metalhead?
No. Why?
Nothing. Just wondering. Go get 'em, heroes.
Okay, so we're supposed to get in a vehicle, right? That's what the controls were? Okay, I guess this one that God apparently selected here with this beam of light. Okay, so we are free to go. Let's see, I've got machine guns and I can hop. Okay, let's see, alright. So we're looking for metal heads. I guess that's what the turtle thing there is. There's 4 of them. Okay, so already flipped. That's good. It's a good start. Okay, so let's see here. I see one up there. I think that's what that is. And there's lots of little green dots in it. It looks like there's one right behind me. Man, we flip easy. Look at that. Okay, so let's see. He's just minding his own business, but I guess I'll take him out. That's what I'm supposed to be doing. Whoa! I have no idea what's happening right now. Okay. Good thing I can flip back over easily. I don't know. What do I need to do to, like, actually take it out, though? I have no idea. That didn't seem to affect it at all. It didn't. Like, I made it stop and turn around, but it didn't seem to hurt it any that I could tell. Like, you can at least tell when they hit because they leave those purple marks. Okay, it's one down. Do we get anything from it? Do I need to, like. Okay. Thought maybe we were supposed to pick something up. Alright. The rest of them are off this way, towards that green sun, I guess. But that wasn't too hard. They didn't even really hurt me. Like, it flipped me over, but I couldn't make out any indication that I was injured by it. Okay, that one went down a lot easier. Okay, so there's just 2 left. I don't know what a metalhead is, honestly. Do they have, like, a culture or a civilization? They were acting like they were, like, an enemy sentient race, but these ones just seem like, you know, like beasts, like dinosaurs or something. They're not. Okay, that time I got hurt. Okay, that one actually hurt me quite a bit, if that's my health bar at the bottom there. I thought those blue orbs were my health, but I guess not. I don't know. Should almost have this one though, I would think, if I can just get closer to it. Yeah, we're gonna, I think, die. Crap, they got me. Okay, there I go. Explode. Okay, so we died. That's good. Oh, but We don't have to redo any. Okay, I was gonna say let's just quit, but since we don't have to redo the two we already got, we apparently have lives. I don't know where it says how many lives we've got left, but since we don't have to redo anything, we'll just hunt them down again. They're not too far out here. I just wish we didn't flip so easy. It's really annoying. Like, I make even the slightest turn and it's like upside down. This thing's way too hard to control for no reason. Like, we've played plenty of games where you try vehicles, even ones that aren't actually racing games, but they usually control better than this. I don't know. Like, I don't know why I keep veering off to the side like that. I'm not telling it to do that. But maybe something to do with the boost. Because I have to hold down X to get any kind of speed going at all. Otherwise, we just kind of list lazily forward. Let's see. I don't know if this is the same one we were shooting at before or not. But it needs... Ugh. I can't aim for crap because it's so hard to control. Okay, so... Hold on. Let's see if I can get this one while I've got it kind of close here. Okay, so one left. And that's over here. I think we can do this. And if that's all there is to this level, we should have time to try at least one more. What's this? Is this some kind of robot head or something? Okay. I can't. I'm stuck against it. I can't turn around. Okay. The other metal head should be right over there if I can get on the right side. Okay. Jeez, wasted a lot of time flipping and getting stuck on heads. That's what I was talking about the controls. Okay. Okay, oh. Here we go. Okay. Look, we didn't even take that much damage. I think I'm hitting it right now. I can't see it. I can't. Here we go. I was trying to get the camera to work with me. Okay, I guess. Okay, but right now it looks like it controls the camera. I don't know why I didn't try that first. I was trying the L2 and R2. Anyway. Wasted a lot of time there. Okay, did we get it? It just went down, it looked like. Nope, okay, it was playing possum, I guess. Did the same animation it looked like that the others do when they go down. I guess, okay, we got it. They're kind of bad. They're such majestic creatures. I guess they're, dangerous, or they have something we want or something, I don't know.
Metalhead Commander, report! What's happening? If you lost that cargo and you're still alive, I'll kill you myself. I want every dark eco crystal you can find! Time is short! Did you hear me? Wait, not you.
I don't like the sound of your voice.
Ha! You sure kicked sand in his face! Oh yeah, that was good.
That face looked familiar.
Now you're getting paranoid, buddy boy. Come on, Bigfoot, let's get back. This desert gives me the creeps.
So I guess metalheads are a monster race that also has a culture? Because the ones I was fighting were definitely just beasts. Like, even calls them metalhead beasts. But then there was, like, one that looked like it was probably humanoid. Anyway, let's explore this eco mine. Looks like we're going to be on foot for this one. With jack controls. Okay. No cutscene this time. We're just here. Alright. Let's explore for a bit. Maybe we'll get some instructions. Okay. Hold L2, then press square. Okay. I became Ice Jack, I guess? I don't know what this does for me. If it's something I want or not.
It looks like some kind of old eco mine. When Mar built Haven City, he must have carved out these old caves to get at the eco power.
Sheesh! That Mar guy must have never slept much.
I'm going ahead to tell Onan we're back. Watch your tail feathers, Jack. This is a spooky place.
That character wasn't in any of the other demos we've played, I don't think. I don't recognize him at all. The little bird monkey thing. Okay, shoot the bridge to make it lower. Wait. Oh, wait. What happened? I just started drifting forward. I hopped on a hoverboard or something, and then I died. I was just trying to see if there was a button I could press to shoot it better, I guess. That was not what I wanted to do. Okay. Well, hold on. We'll try that again. Let's see here. Does it... said to shoot the bridge. This is the only shoot thing I'm aware of. Everything else is like melee attacks that I've got. And what is this that I... okay. So I can use this to like hover around, but it can't hover over non-floors. So I can't use it to like get closer to the bridge or something. I'm trying to hold it. Thought maybe that would help, but no. Maybe Ice Jack can shoot it better. Nope. Even jumping towards it doesn't work. Okay. This is dumb. It's not explaining anything to me though in a way that it makes sense. I get that I have to shoot the bridge. I guess. Doesn't seem like the best way to lower a bridge, but whatever. I don't know. There's gotta be something else to do around here. If I had to shoot, like, a control thing or something, that would make a lot more sense to me. Something I could reach. That is the bridge, right? Wait, I have more than one gun? Why didn't it tell me I had more than one? How do I switch between them? Because I ended up just having to use up all of that one in order to get this. Okay, whatever. Are these things metalheads too? Or are they just animals? I don't know. But anyway, we've got this, and now this is what we're supposed to be using to cross bridges, I guess. Not very good with it. I don't remember shooting a lot of things in the other ones. Was this like a different feature? Crap, no, what? I thought it was fine. Jeez, and it brings me all the way back here. It's so far. It's not that far, but it was really tedious to have to come all the way back here just because I decided to kick something. I wanted to use a melee attack to break that box because it seems like I have a limited number of bullets and I didn't want to waste them. But I guess that was dumb of me. Okay, at least I don't have to use up all of that other gun again. But I still have to shoot these bridges again, which is kind of annoying. Let's see. Also, all these animals came back. So some stuff respawns when you die. I was hoping we wouldn't have to redo anything other than like level progression, since we didn't have to re-kill any of the metalheads in the other stage, but I guess that was wishful thinking. So I guess I'm just gonna shoot everything. Because while we're up here, I'm afraid to do kicks and stuff, because I'm not used to how Jack moves. And I don't want him to go flying off the side again and get me killed. So, let's see. I guess we need to go this way. If I want to break something, I can't trust myself to not die while trying to. This is lowering us somewhere. Where are we going? Over here, I guess. Okay. Whoa, what? There was no indication that was going to happen! God, I hate this freaking game. You know what? Screw it. I don't want to play this level anymore. Let's try the last one. Okay, this is an escort mission, I guess. This is to escort the bomb train. I just don't have the patience to do that level, like, 100 times. Okay, we're back here again. What am I supposed to be doing? Okay. Wait. Oh, wait, it didn't tell me what to do! Okay, so I have to shoot shoot these bridges, I guess? He won't look at it! He just keeps moving, the cursor keeps moving past where I'm trying to shoot. Okay, so I need to shoot that, and I guess come down here and try to shoot this. Can't get him to turn the right way, though. There we go. Okay. And I guess it'll come down here and I have to get to that? How am I supposed to get over there? I don't know how to shoot that one. I'm trying. Oh, there, now I got it. Oh, great, okay. I'm not sure I really get this. Maybe some of this stuff would make more sense if I had played the game a bit more instead of just hopping to these levels, but as it is, I don't feel like I'm adequately equipped to handle some of this stuff. Let's see. Like the, what was it? The freaking... Oh, hold on. There's another thing I have to shoot. Come on. We have to get on the jet board now, it says? Okay. Alright. Have to grind across this. Like, this is... I don't know. I want to like this. This seems like a neat idea for a level. It's just frustrating because I don't know what I'm doing. And I don't know, something about this game puts me in a bad mood. I can't even explain that. It's just something about it. It's too Jack, I guess. I really don't know why it bothers me like it does. There's no reason I can think of why it should. I hope I didn't miss any. Oh, there's one. Okay. Trying to figure out where the next thing I need to shoot is. But got more of these flying lamprey things. Got that one. Okay, we're doing pretty good now that I've got the hang of it. Very first time we got here, I had no idea what I was even supposed to be doing. Okay, this is like the Incredibles all over again. Wait, crap, I don't know how to get past this thing. I don't see any other way to go. Whatever, I don't care. I think that's where we're gonna stop. I'm not... Like, there's no way I'm redoing all that. It's just too much to redo from scratch. It's not fun. Alright, next up is the Dukes of Hazzard, Return of the General Lee. Yeah. I don't really know what else to say to set up a Dukes of Hazzard game. I think we played this game in episode 42, in the second half of that episode, with Alex back on the Xbox. I'm fairly certain it's the same Dukes of Hazzard game. I don't remember off the top of my head if that's the same subtitle. And frankly, I don't really care. I have a feeling, even if it is a different game, I probably won't notice. But, oh, there's a yeehaw button. That's good. I never really watched the Dukes of Hazzard. I'll just go ahead and say I think I've seen one or two episodes. I mostly know it more as the pop culture thing, just through meiosis, I guess. It's not something that ever appealed to me particularly. Like, none of the things I associate with the brand are things that I am interested in. But here it is.
Just a good old boy.
Welcome back to Hazzard County. You'll find things pretty much the way you left them. Culture and good breeding are still the rule.
Don't you dare!
All right, Jesse Dukes, you get that rattletrap out of the way. This here's an official vehicle.
Hold your horses, Roscoe.
Dad, blame fool. The local law is still the model of courtesy and kindness. And if you believe that, I'll tell you another. Most ways, people just been going about their business.
That's new, man. Fine day, ain't it?
Okay. I don't remember there being a cutscene like that in the demo we played on the Xbox. But I could be wrong. I thought there was some kind of setup for the game at the start, but I don't remember like that specific opening. But this looks really familiar. So, he was telling me something there, but I went ahead and selected a new game. I pressed X before I realized that there was going to be more than just a howdy, y'all. Took a second to back.
Brew is the smell of victory. Now all we need is enough paint for our little surprise, and that entry form is ours.
Uncle Jesse!
Here comes trouble.
You must have scared Boss Hogg something awful. He's gonna tear down the orphanage right now. There's bulldozers all over town and a demolition crew on its way, Uncle Jesse.
Well, what are we waiting for?
You boys got to get that paint. Cooter can stop the bulldozers and Daisy'll handle the demolition team.
None of that made sense to me. I got that there's an orphanage at stake, but everything that I just heard, I'm assuming if I'd been playing the game up to this point, maybe it would make a little bit more sense, but it was barely registered as English to me. So we're getting paint, I guess, in order to save an orphanage that's about to be bulldozed. I don't know how. Is the orphanage not going to be bulldozed if it has like a new coat of paint? Pick ourselves up a tail. Cool. Okay. Wow. This car turns weird. All right. Once I get the hang of controlling this, we'll be okay. Oh, there's the tail. Okay. Hello, officer. Fine day this evening. It's not even evening. I don't know when this is supposed to be taking place. But anyway, I guess I don't. Maybe that was all a part of my tactic to lose him. Wait, can I get through this? Okay, that one I can get through, so it's not the most serious one. Okay. So, this does seem like the same demo we played. I just didn't remember that opening. And I'm still not positive the version we played had that opening. I think it did have the scene with them all in the garage or whatever. That part seemed a little bit more familiar than the larger setup. There, this cop won't get off my side. I was gonna say get off my back, but he's really still coming in at the side. I thought he flipped over a while back, but maybe there's more than one. If I knew how to drive this better and could drive without running, like, I don't need this cop to stop me from hitting, or to make me hit fences and stuff. I've been doing it on my own just fine. For whatever reason, this car really likes to veer when I just try to make a slight turn. Oh good, this part's straight, it says. But it's not. I don't know why it gave me that sign. God, stop. It's like if I tap one direction, it thinks I want to make a right turn that direction. That is not to say that I'm turning to the right, but that I'm making a 90-degree turn. Which is not usually the case. Usually I'm just trying to straighten up a little bit because it's pointed slightly the wrong direction. But here I can do a little bit. But if I get any speed going, I have to basically come to a complete stop to adjust my turning.
The gates are locked. How are we going to get that paint now?
How are we going to get the paint? Canal round the back? Okay, we have to take a drainage canal. That sounds familiar. Kind of remember doing that.
Take the dirt road coming up on the right. There's a shortcut we can take.
Okay. Yeah, I'm gonna take this shortcut. Jeez, I can't get rid of this car. I don't even understand what the cop's wanting from me. Nothing. What am I doing that's illegal? And why is the sheriff trying to tear down an orphanage? Like, how is that even his, like, jurisdiction? Nothing makes sense in this world. I don't understand it.
Oh, shoot.
He got me stopped. Oh, come on, I could have still gotten around him. I wasn't any more stopped than I was at any other point. I don't know why that counted. I guess that's it. Just kind of stopped there. Okay. Let's move on. So our last game here is Killzone. As I mentioned, this is the featured game on the disc that's on the actual disc image there. So I hope it's fun. I've been trying to think, and I don't think we've had Killzone on this show before. It almost feels like it, just because I've seen Killzone a lot. We've had similar games on here, and it seems like something I'm familiar with, but I'm fairly certain I've never actually played it. I just have a firm idea of what Killzone is in my mind because I've seen the imagery to it a lot. Hold on, what's invert look? That might be the camera. Let's have that turned off. If that's inverting the camera axis. You got three characters: Rico, Luger, and Templar. Okay, I'm gonna do Luger. no real reason. Just of the three, looked like the more likable one, I guess. I'm assuming they play different. And this one probably looks more like the stealth character from just the look. Yeah, Shadow Marshal Luger. So I'm assuming this character is probably going to be the one I like playing the least, because that's the least similar to my playstyle. But you know, who knows? Okay. I thought maybe I had a sniper rifle, but instead I assumed I have some kind of machine gun. Okay, well, if I was supposed to be stealthy, I already messed it up. But is this guy still down here? Come on. Almost got him. Okay. There we go. Okay. I'm just assuming I'm supposed to be killing people. That's all. I don't know. Like, there was some text there describing what's happening. I didn't actually read it. I know I complain a lot about not getting context in these types of games. But, I just didn't. But, yeah, this is basically exactly what I pictured. This is just what I pictured Killzone would be. So, I guess the branding's been effective. It got across the product to me pretty well. I want to be hunched down, I think. There's more people over here. Oh, hello. Found them. Okay. I'm, not doing super great here. I don't know if this is like a... I guess this is a story mode. So there's my ally characters. Okay, I was gonna say, I don't know if this is like progressing through a typical level, or if we're in something more like the multiplayer, I assume, is. Because I'm assuming, since it's an FPS game, that there's a big multiplayer faction to it, or facet to it. But I really don't know. Like, as much as I was talking about, like, seeing Killzone all over the place and recognizing the imagery of it, I don't actually know anything about it, like, in terms of, like, a story or what have you. I'm trying to see if I can open this somehow. But, I keep trying to interact with some of these plates and things. Nothing's working. Hold on, let's try cutting and stuff. I don't know what I'm assuming we want to go through this door. This is what it looks like. Do you guys know how to open this door? Or are we just gonna stand here? Because I've tried every button. Oops, except that one. Sorry, you want mine not sitting next to it? Jeez, took him too long to stand up and move. Okay. I don't know, maybe it's not possible for me to actually hurt him. I don't know. He didn't seem all that concerned about it. Let's try... Let's see, we can't go that way. Maybe we can get across. Maybe that's what we're supposed to be doing. Okay. Yeah, I guess this is it. Did we clear enough? Okay. I thought that was a person for a second. I was just investigating. It's like, they weren't shooting at me. There's another door identical to the one I couldn't open just now, but... This way, we can go this way. Okay. Okay. It didn't work. I was completely overblown there. We'll just linger on my corpse for a long time. That's good. Okay. Well, hold on. Let's see where it brings me. If it brings me back to the same spot, like roughly where we died, that's one thing, but... Wait, is this... Okay, yeah, this is the start of the level again. Okay, I didn't recognize these things, so I didn't know what was going on. I don't want to restart the whole level. I don't care that much. You got a pretty good idea of what the game's like. I doubt there was anything all that surprising past the point where I died, other than just more people to shoot. But that's Killzone. It is what it is. I'm not the target audience at all, but it seems fine, I guess. The harsh realities of war in a gritty, awe-inspiring FPS. I do like that. I guess it doesn't glorify war, try to clean it up. 25 weapons, 11 levels, 4 playable characters, 6 online modes, and a gripping storyline, it claims. I'll have to take its word for it, but yeah, November 2004. And that's it for this disc. Kind of a lackluster sigh of an ending for what was an otherwise really fun disc. Like Killzone, I will immediately forget everything about it that I learned today, and just keep remembering those masks, which is really all that I've ever known about it, I guess. But like, Incredibles was fine, I guess. Fairly OddParents was a lot more fun than I thought it'd be. Spyro was fun. Suikoden was pretty interesting. I wish I had more time to play games like that, because it was pretty fun. We didn't get to play King Arthur, unfortunately. Under the Skin was amazing. This is a game I would have owned if I had known about it at the time, and might still look into getting it at some point, because that was a lot of fun. Jack 3 was kind of frustrating, but that was mostly due to my own incompetence. Dukes of Hazzard was harmless, and Killzone was whatever. It was fine. I didn't hate any of these games, I don't think. Even probably the closest I came to hating one was Jack 3. I was in a pretty bad mood at the end of that, but I don't even know if that was the game's fault. But anyway, thank you guys for watching. I hope you had fun, because I certainly did. And if you did, you know, come back next week and we'll play another demo, whatever I can find. I'll see you guys then. Bye.